six simple actions that will lead me and you, inshallah, to be in the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There's no doubt that Jannah is the ultimate goal for every true believer. And to be in the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that is really everybody's hope. So let's remind each other of few things that we can do بإذن الله تعالى in order to attain that high position. First, loving Allah and His Messenger. A man came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, Ya Rasulullah, when is the hour? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answered him with a question. He said, what have you prepared for it? The man said, Ya Rasulullah, I did not prepare much salat, much fasting, and much zakat, but I love Allah and I love His Messenger. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said the beautiful statement, you will be with those whom you love. Because of your love to Allah and your love to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will be in the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Anas, the narrator of the hadith, he said, after accepting Islam, nothing has ever brought us happiness more than this statement. Because we all love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and we would love to be with him in Jannah. Thawban radiallahu anhu came one time to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, I love you so much. And when I'm with you, I'm very happy. But when I go home, I miss you a lot. And I was thinking that you will be in the highest place in Jannah. And I have no clue if I'm going to be in Jannah or not. And I'm going to miss you a lot. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not answer him. And Allah Azza wa Jal from above seventh heaven sent Jibreel to tell Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولِ Whomsoever obey Allah and obey the Prophet, he will be with the Nabiyeen. He will be with the company of the prophets, all of them, and specifically Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the first is loving and obeying Allah and His Messenger. Second, performing a lot of salat. We all know the story of Rabi'a. Rabi'a is a young man that loved to serve Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he used to stay by his door in case Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam got up at night and asked for water for wudu. He will be right there to serve Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So one day, Rabi'a got an offer that every Muslim dream about. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Rabi'a, Ya Rabi'a, ask me, what do you want, Ya Rabi'a? Allahu Akbar. And Rabi'a, radiallahu anhu, look how smart, very young man, 10, 11, at that age, what did he ask for? Did he ask to get married? Did he ask for a house? Did he ask for a horse? What did he ask for? He said, Ya Rasulullah, I want your company in Jannah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, help me help you, like we say. If you want that, make a lot of sujood. Sujood here means a lot of salat. Anything else, Ya Rabi'a? You know what Rabi'a said? No, that's it, Ya Rasulullah. That's all I want. Allahu Akbar. Third, good manners. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, should I inform you about the most beloved people to me and the closest to me on the Day of Judgment? He said, yes, Ya Rasulullah. He said, the ones with the greatest manners. My beloved brothers and sisters, this is something that we are missing. We see brothers and sisters 5 daily prayers. We see sisters with niqab, with hijab. We see brothers that give a lot of money. We see brothers that go to hajj all the time. But when it comes to manners, when it comes to treatment to others, they fail big time. When it comes to treatment to their spouse, they fail a lot. Being kind, being loving, being caring, being generous, being forgiving, overlooking other people's faults, covering other people's faults, being concerned, visiting our sick brothers. This is something that we are missing. The one with the greatest manners, he will be the closest to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The woman that fasts all day and up all night, but Ya Rasulullah, she harms her neighbor with her tongue. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, she's in the hellfire. Allahu Akbar. So she's performing the ibadat, but she is way behind in her manners. Manners and acts of worship, they go hand in hand. Fourth, subhanAllah, how much respect and honor and reward our deen gave to women. Jannah under the mother's feet. The best of you, the best of their wives. And today, subhanAllah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, whomsoever bring up 2 daughters or 2 sisters or 3 sisters till they reach the age of marriage, or he dies before that, he and I will be like this in Jannah. Allahu Akbar. Raising righteous daughters, taking care of sisters and raising them properly on Islam will be the reason for us to attain the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannah. Number 5, sponsoring an orphan. We all know this hadith that Rasulullah ﷺ said, me and the one who take care of the orphan is like this in Jannah. 6th and last, making a lot of salat on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad, kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, innaka hamidun majid. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the one who make a lot of salat upon me will be the closest to me in Jannah. I ask Allah azza wa jal with the best of his names, ya Allah, grant us the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Allah, we have been deprived from seeing him in this dunya. Please do not deprive us from meeting him in Jannah.